sex is to be next
at the feast on the green.
On the green, oh be sure. And that bride of his sexes, of his sexes to be next
at the feast on the green.
Joy, because the young and amiable Alexis heir to the great Sir Marmaduke Poindexter is plighted to Aline, the only daughter of Annabella, Lady Sangazure. You alone are sad and out of spirit. What is the reason? Speak, my daughter, speak.
No, mother, do not ask if my complexion from red to white should change in quick succession.
though that was long ago. Who is the object of your young affection?
Hush, Mother! He is here!
Our Reverend Vicar!
Pity me, my heart is almost broken!
Oh, my child, be comforted! To such an union I shall not offer any opposition! Take him, he's yours! May you and he be happy!
But, Mother dear, he is not yours to give!
Oh, that's true indeed.
He might object.
He might. But come, take heart. I'll probe him on the subject. Be comforted. Leave this affair to me.
Pale young curate,
on me, I
Good Mrs. Parklet, I am glad to see you. And your little daughter Constance. Why, she is quite a little woman, I declare.
Oh, Mother, I cannot speak to him.
Yes, Reverend Sir. She is nearly 80 and as good a girl as ever stepped.
Ah, Sir, I'm afraid I shall soon lose her.
Dear me, you pain me very much. Is she delicate?
No, sir!
I don't mean that!
But young girls look to get married!
Oh, I take you. To be sure, but there's plenty of time for that. 4 or 5 years hence, Mrs. Partlet. 4 or 5 years hence. But when the time does come, I shall take great pleasure in marrying her myself.
Oh, Mother!
To some strapping young fellow in her own rank of life.
He does not love me!
I have often wondered, Reverend Sir, if you'll excuse the liberty, that you have never married.
Be still, my fluttering heart.
A clergyman's wife does so much good in a village! Besides, you are not as young as you once were. Before very long, you will want somebody to nurse you and look after your little comfort.
Mrs. Partlet, there is much truth in what you say. I am indeed getting on in years, and a helpmate would cheer my declining days. Time was when it might have been. But I am too old now. I'm an old fogey now, am I not, my dear? A very old fogey indeed. No, Mrs. Partlet, my mind is quite made up. I shall live and die a solitary old bachelor.
Oh, Mother! Mother!
Come, dear one, don't fret! At a more fitting time, we will try again. We will try again.
Poor little girl. I think she has something on her mind. She is rather comely. Time was when this old heart would have throbbed in double time at the sight of such a fairy form. Oh, but tush, I'm puling.
Ole!
Ah, here comes Alexis and his proud and happy father. Let me dry this telltale tear. Sir Marmaduke, my dear young friend Alexis, on this most happy, most auspicious plighting, permit me as a true old friend to tender my best, my very best congratulations. Sir, you are most obliging.
Dr. Daly, my dear old tutor, and my valued pastor, I thank you from the bottom of my heart.
May fortune bless you. May the middle distance of your young life be as pleasant as the foreground. When you have reached it, may that which is now the far-off horizon, but which will then become the middle distance, in fruitful promise be exceeded only by that which will, in the meantime, have opened into a new and glorious horizon.
Dear sir, that is an excellent example of an old school of stately compliment to which I have through life been much. Will you oblige me with a copy of it in clerkly manuscript that I may use it myself on appropriate occasions?
Sir, you shall have a copy in fair hand ere Sol has sunk into her western slumbers.